You world, behave yourselves. You people in China, behave yourselves. Stop fighting. You people in Indonesia, stop yelling about independence.
I love you.
Dr. Shapley? I'm proposing to talk tonight about peaceful atomic abundance. A new era was born when several thousand scientists, simultaneously stricken by the horror of their accomplishment, reached out as one man for a social conscience. They have long known what the American people are just beginning to know, that all of us, both individually and collectively, are now facing the greatest challenge ever placed before man. We can turn toward darkness, destruction, and death, or toward light, peace, and abundance. The bomb uncontrolled.
I've said enough
about the peacetime possibilities of atomic energy. It is important that everybody be aware of not only the dangers, but also the advantages which this new atomic era brings. We are headed toward full peacetime interchange of the useful values of atomic energy between scientists of all industries and nations. Thank God the key to the atom is owned by all the people and not by those creatures of special privilege who would hide behind a military or industrial cloak to use this new device to bring the peoples of the world into subjection to atomic imperialism. We who are here tonight know that no organization, however powerful, will ever prevent war if the causes of war are not removed. Therefore, I say that atomic energy, constructively applied to raising the standard of living of all peoples, will do infinitely more to eliminate war than any type of control over atomic bombs. And so that every nation in its own way and in cooperation with other nations may discover new peacetime uses. No one today can predict with accuracy the possible peacetime uses 1 year, 5 years, or 20 years hence. We do know that within a year, a fairly efficient atomic power could be constructed. We do know that a pound of uranium fully utilized would produce approximately as much heat as 1,000,000 pounds of coal. We are certain that atomic energy in large power plants will have many advantages over coal. Undoubtedly, there will be great atomic power plants in areas of the world where coal, petroleum, and water power are not now conveniently available. The most pronounced effect may be to enable certain so-called backward areas to jump over the ages of steam and electricity directly into the new era. The Arctic regions and the tropics may take on an importance which otherwise would have been unimaginable. While there's some difference of opinion, it seems fairly certain to me that altogether new methods of distributing power will be discovered, and that eventually small, safe motors for using atomic power will be worked out. Undoubtedly, there will be produced tremendous quantities of radioactive substances, which will have widespread application in biology, agriculture, and medicine. All these people therefore take the form of reasonable royalties from non-exclusive licenses available to all. There would be no threat to public safety in peaceful economic utilization of atomic power under proper regulations, because the harnessing of this power for useful work is based upon principles different from those involved in the release of such energy for destructive purposes. The first is based upon the control of the reaction, and the second upon the sudden release of all controls. In the wartime development of atomic energy, the United States obtained the cooperation of hundreds of scientists born in Germany, Russia, Italy, Hungary, Denmark, France, England, and many other countries. The United States can make an enormous contribution to this development as part of a great cooperative effort. But the genius of science is worldwide. Any attempt to go it alone and in secret would soon result only in the impoverishment of our own science. Armed conflict in an atomic energy world is certain suicide. It is clear today that the future of the world will depend more than ever before on the development of science. The scientific research of the world will have to be combined, guided, and crystallized for the benefit of all mankind. For today we are on the threshold of an era of abundance, and we must not permit those who hold the key for the time being, for one reason or another, to obstruct the way to general happiness. We do not have to have social revolutions. We do not have to have wars. We have been given, through the fantastic discovery of atomic energy, the unique opportunity to build one single human community on the highest spiritual level, accompanied by unlimited material facilities. We can war, and the final state of man will be 10 times as miserable as it has ever been. We must move with speed, determination, and faith. The stakes are the human race. We cannot fail. We cannot delay. The awe-inspiring responsibility is ours for a short time only. The war we won was a people's war. The peace we win must be a people's peace.